It's a real pleasure to be here today. As we've heard from the other speakers, I'm going to try and show you how we've been able to combine the power of genomics with large amounts of data combined with machine learning to really innovate and develop an early stage cancer screening test called Galleri by leveraging the power of machine learning and genomics. Cancer is a worry for many of us, if not most of us. In 2020, there were more than 19 million cases of cancer globally, nearly 10 million deaths. It's expected that 1 in 3 men and 1 in 4 women are likely to get cancer during their lifetime. Will I or a family member be diagnosed with cancer? Where is it in my body? Can it be cured? Or is it going to kill me? These are common questions that many of us share. Cancer, when detected late, is deadly. In fact, if you're able to detect cancer early when it is localized, it is expected that 9 out of 10 individuals will be able to live 5 years or more. Unfortunately, that number comes down to 2 when cancer is detected late. 71% of cancer-related deaths today are in cancers with no recommended screening. We at GRAIL see a better way, a much more personalized way. Instead of only screening for individual cancers, we need to screen individuals for cancer. And this is now possible thanks to 2 big technology revolutions that have happened over the last 20 years. First is the power of genomics. It is now possible to sequence the complete DNA, more than 3 billion base pairs of information, generating terabytes of data cost effectively within a few days. Second is the huge amount of innovations in machine learning. We now have the technology, we now have the know-how to be able to build complicated deep learning models with tens and millions of parameters, to be able to capture complexity cost effectively at scale. These 2 paradigms are the foundations on which Galleri, our multi-cancer early detection test, is built. When the cells die, shed small pieces of DNA within the bloodstream. These bits of information have information on the origin associated with from where the cancer is coming. Further, there are more than 30 million regions of the genome that are associated with epigenetic factors or methylation factors that help us pinpoint if there is a signal for cancer or not. This is what powers the underlying technology behind GRAIL's test. It is changes within the methylation pattern. In fact, if you look at Galleri, our multi-cancer early detection test, it is able to detect more than 50 types of cancers with a false positive rate of 0.5%. Clinically, one of the most relevant numbers is something called PPV, that is the positive predictive value, that is the likelihood that an individual has cancer when the test is positive. Remember, for individual test, this number is in the single digits. For Galleri, it is estimated to be at 44. Further, in the case where there is a cancer signal and the individual has cancer, we are able to pinpoint the origin of the cancer 89% of the times. So to summarize, Galleri is a multi-cancer early detection test that is designed to detect most cancers, complement, not replace, recommended single cancer screening test. It is designed to optimize the overall cancer detection while minimizing harms. Our modeling shows that Galleri has the potential to save lives. If you look at the graph on the left-hand side, the gray bars show how cancer is detected today. many, if not most of it, in the late stages. By introducing Galleri, it is estimated that we are able, which is the green bars, that we are able to flip that and detect most of those cancers early in the early stages. Our modeling shows that by adding Galleri to 5 US recommended screenings, that could potentially avert more than 100,000 deaths annually. All of this would not have been possible without the huge amount of investments that we have made to be able to build one of the largest genomic databases, especially methylation-based. It's a combination of longitudinal medical records combined together with genomic information that we will continue to invest and power and underpin the classifier that we are building. Leveraging the power of genomics and machine learning needs a lot of computation. Very large amounts of data need to be collected and scaled. It would not have been possible to do this without the close partnership with AWS. We leverage many of their services, for example, for storage, S3, S3IA, intelligent tiering, the use of Glacier, Deep Archive, the use of RDS for relational databases, DynamoDB for non-SQL databases, and Redshift for data warehousing. Being able to do this complicated assay, looking for those bits of information, needs a lot of computation. We of course leverage EC2 instances, specifically Spot instances, to keep our costs down, along with leveraging some of the other services such as Lambda for serverless compute, as well as EKS and Fargate for our distributed computing frameworks. Security and infrastructure is a key part of being able to keep our data safe and scale it. Of course, we leverage VPCs with our public and private subnets, with security groups, with network access control layers, all built in, along with many of the other services such as CloudWatch, AWS Config, and the use of KMS to be able to build the security across the data. It would have been very difficult for us to innovate and build the assay as well as the classifier without leveraging the scale of AWS. Next, let me walk you through how the classifier is built and what the assay looks like. As with most machine learning problems, you first have to create a training set, which consists of blood samples from both healthy individuals as well as from cancer patients. Remember, we're looking for the small fragments of DNA, changes within the methylation regions, to be able to detect signs of cancer. These epigenetic parameters need to be detected through a process where there is sequencing, which can take multiple days, generates, again, terabytes of data from a flow cell. And there are large amounts of compute that we distribute across hundreds of EC2 nodes to be able to generate those key parameters, tens of thousands of parameters that flow into a classifier. In essence, the input to the classifier is a 0 or a 1. The classifier then makes a prediction, and this is an ensemble model, of whether there is a signal for cancer. And in the case of a signal, it also makes a prediction of what is the origin of that cancer. Building such a complicated assay as well as a classifier is underpinned by the software engineering team. One of the key pieces that we built on very early on is to provide our data scientists and the bioinformaticians an ability to iterate independent of worrying about scaling as well as the underlying operations and infrastructure. We've given them a framework by which they can iterate on the classifier, they can iterate on the assay, and then operationalize it independently. In essence, software engineering at GRAIL consists of 5 main areas of work. First is the many clinical trials that we run. We run some of the largest clinical trials, blood-based clinical trials, such as the one that is currently in progress, working very closely with NHS Galleri. Second is lab software that is responsible for running the workflow when a sample comes into the lab to finally generating the report. There's levels of automation that allow us to run all of these workflows in parallel. Next is commercial software, which includes an ability to be able to order the test, integrate with the EMR, generate the results. Fourth is our distributed computing platform that underpins all of the compute as well as the storage to be able to power this through at very large scales. Data is pervasive at Grail, and we have a large amounts of investments within the area to normalize it, manage it, and govern it. We've also invested a lot in automation, as well as being able to create immutable environments. And all of this is done with design control in place by building in tests and quality and security in place. To summarize, hopefully this has provided you an overview of the innovation that is possible by combining the power of large data sets, genomics, and by machine learning. Thank you.